Of course you do. When I found out what he did to Margaret, I wanted to kill the man with my bare hands. But he saved my life. I owe him something.
I never wish anybody dead, okay? But if people are going to start throwing him a welcome back from the great party, I'd just as soon stay home and watch.
No, I don't think anybody's going to be throwing any parties. But the fact is, he's alive and he's back, so I'm going to have to deal with Todd. Okay, do you know where he is right now?
I guess he's with Blair and Little Star, so let's question him tomorrow.
Let's? No. Kemosabe, we are not going to question anybody at all.
The Southland's number one station for news at 6.
Let me get this straight. Todd climbs out of his grave and you don't question him.
I have a question for Todd. Why didn't he stay in the grave where he belonged?
Time. I'm not saying that Todd should not be questioned, okay? It's just that guy and I aren't exactly golfing buddies. Not after what he did to Nora.
That's fair enough, all right? If he won't cooperate with you, send one of your men over.
You're not hearing me. Todd's allergic to authority.
So what are you saying? We're back to square one? We don't do anything? We leave him alone?
Yes.
No. There is somebody that he might talk to.
And who's that?
You.
Your husband's a bloody riot. First you tell me stay away from Poseidon. It's police work. And don't be a loose cannon.
I'm still saying all of that, okay? I'm just instructing you to please listen. Just listen to what Todd has to say. That's all right. And then if that stubborn Irishman inside you decides that he wants to do something...
Wait. Are you deputizing me? Give me a gun. Give me a badge. Give me something.
No. Sorry there, Wild Bill. No, I'm just asking you to talk to Todd, you know? And just see if there's anything that he knows about a connection between Carlo and Poseidon. You can handle that, can't
sure.
you?
Offer me a beer or something.
No, thanks. No, listen, have a good night, Patrick, okay? I know what you're thinking. It's not right for me to ask a civilian to do police work. But what's the alternative, you know? Patrick goes off on his own. At least this way we've got somebody working on the inside, right? Right. Honey, Todd is not going to talk to cops. But maybe he will talk to Patrick and he can find out what he knows about Carlo.
You're playing a dangerous game here, Bill. Very dangerous. Todd Manning is far too unpredictable, not to mention vindictive.
Yes, that's what I'm counting on, honey. Don't you get it? When Todd decides that he wants to do something to get even, I want to make sure that he knows that Carlo Hesser is the person responsible. In a minute.
Oh, Bo.
Honey, I know how you feel about Todd, but if he can help us get the goods on Carlo...
Todd helps Todd. He will use everybody else to get what he wants. If you and Patrick think that you can control him...
No, I just want to find out what he knows. That's all. You never can tell. Maybe the Todd Manning that came back is a whole different guy.
A snake will shed its skin, but it's still a snake.
We're talking about a little more than skin. The guy died, or at least he came as close as you can come, no? Something like that happens, it can have a very strong effect on your personality.
He died before, remember? What changed then?
Boy, that's some mother you got. I'm back in the house with her now.
Saddest sight in the world, seeing your wife pack to go out of town without you.
It's just filling, and it's just for business.
Hmm.
course, there's a little side trip with Abdul, but you don't want to know about that, trust me.
You're mocking me. Leaving me all alone in that vast Siberian wasteland up there that used to be our bed. Plus, you know, I could use your help keeping an eye on Asus so he doesn't just take off on his own, try to lynch Carlo the minute my back's turned.
There are a lot of police officers outside of his house, Bill. That's what they're there for. Didn't the little man explain it to you?
I've got faith in my people.
Okay.
I do. They're the best. But Asa, I mean, his taste for revenge, that's a whole different situation. He told me that he wasn't planning anything against Carlo, but I believe that he's got an ugly little surprise up his sleeve. And God, I hate ugly little surprises. Yeah.
You know, I don't have to be there for a while. Why don't we go by Aces? And we'll put the fear of God in him.
Honey, if he's planning a coup, I'm not sure that the fear of God could even stop him. We're talking about Asa Buchanan here. We're talking about the guy that acted like he was more cracked than the Liberty Bell just so he could trap Carlo and Alex and make them pay for the sins against him.
Sweetheart, the last time, when he acted crazy, look what that got him. It got him committed to Mountain View. He's learned his lesson by now. Well, then it would make him think twice, though, you know, because... Never mind, you're right.
No, I think you've got a point.
I do?
Yeah.
Which one?
We should go over there. Just talk to him, you know? See if maybe we can get something out of him. Maybe he'll tilt his hand a little bit.
Let's go.
I'm right behind you.
Ooh.
No, Davey, I don't want to go through...
If I was your daddy, I'd 10-year hide.
You know, now that we have a mole inside of Carlo's operation, maybe we can get the goods on him, put him away once and for all.
That's if Antonio is privy to the information you need for an indictment.
You're starting to sound like a lawyer, honey.
Oh.
This thing is over with. We are gonna go on a vacation.
Oh. Can we make it a family vacation? Take Drew and Rachel with us?
Yeah, I think that's a great idea. I think that I've been neglecting Drew lately. I mean, lately. When he came to town, I was right in the middle of the Poseidon adventure. Since then, things haven't slowed down long enough for us to even kick back and kind of get to know each other. So I think it's a great idea for a family vacation.
Great. I might even come back from Philadelphia then. Well, you never know.
I always know.
You take me for granted, Bob. You can.
Yeah, you love it.
Hey, you,
what?
Buddy. Listen, you're gonna kiss me. You kiss me. Don't kiss me in any random thought that happens to come between us.
I don't have random thoughts. I have an extremely ordered mind.
Lately, you've been lucky to walk out of the house with your shoelaces tied.
What are you talking about? They're tied.
Oh, those are Italian loafers. They don't even have any laces. I gotta get going.
You know, the last time I talked to Drew, I had the feeling that he wanted to tell me something. And then he never did.
Could it have been about Rachel? Maybe he wants a father-son talk.
I don't know. It could be. I haven't had much experience in that department, so maybe I missed something. I missed him growing up. You know, the damnedest thing is, I still don't understand why I had to miss that. Buchanan. What? Hey, Linda? Listen. Hey, I can hardly hear you. All right? I'm going to call you back on a payphone. All right.
Likely story, having to call Linda back on a payphone. Why, couldn't you talk in front of me?
Honey, you might as well know. I've been cheating on you with another John.
You know, I'm going to go use the ladies' room, and then I will settle up with you when I get back.
All right, whenever you're ready.
Okie dokie. Which way is it? The ladies' room?
Oh, it's in the lobby.